In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Et pro vivo alba tali Dei. In nomine Deus et discerne causa meum de gentium non sancta abomine iniquo et doloso errore me. Emite lucem tuam et veritatem tuam ipse mei deduc servant, et deduc servant in montum sanctum tuam et in tabernacula tua. Compite vor tibi in cifra Deus Deus meus quale tristis es anima mea quale conturbas me. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Intro vivo adotari Dei. Agitorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Conviter Deo omnipotente Beata Maria Semper Virgin. Beato Michele Arcangelo, Beati Ioanni Baptiste, Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis et Vobis Fratres, quia peccavi nimis cogitatione verbo docere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa, et io prego Beata Maria Semper Virgin, Beato Michele Arcangelo, Beato Ioanni Baptiste, Sanctus Apostolos Petro et Paolo, Omnes Sanctos et Vobis Fratres, orare pro mea, Domine Deo nostrum. Misericordia vestri omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis vestris perduca vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam, absolutionem, remissionem peccatorum nostrorum, tribuat nobis omnipotens et misericordes dominus. Deus tu conversus vivi cabis nos. Ostende nobis Domine misericordiam tuam. Domine exaudi oratione meam. In dominus vobiscum. In medio ecclesiae alterni vos Deus, et in plebi Deum Dominus Spiritus Sapientiae et Intellectus. Solam glorie in lui Deum, alleluia, alleluia. Bonum est confitere Domino, et salve nomine tuo altissime. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicur erat in principio, et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In medio ecclesiae apparui Deus Deus, et in plebi Deo Dominus Spiritus Sapientiae et Intellectus, stolam gloriae in lui Deum, alleluia, alleluia.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie
eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Christe eleison,
Christe eleison,
Christe eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison, gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax, omnibus boni voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratias agimus tibi, propter mandum, gloriam tuam. Domine Deus, rex celestis, Deus Pater omnipotens. Domine Fili unigenite, Iesu Christe. Domine Deus, annus Dei, filius Patris. Vitolis peccata mundi miserere nobis. Vitolis peccata mundi suscipe de precatione nostra. Qui sedes ad exterum Patris miserere nobis. Uniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum sanctus spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Deus, qui populo tuo, aeterne salutis, beatum Gregorium ministrum tribuisti, presta presos, ut quem doctorum vitae habuimus in terris, intercessorum habere meriamur in cedis, per Domino nostrum Iesu Christum filium tuum, in te convide et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Divi Sapientiae. Justus Corsum adet ad vigilandum viruculo adonium. Qui vigilio, et in conspecto altissimi de precavito. Aperiet ossum in oratione, et pro diricti suis de precavito. Si eni dominus manus voluerit, spiritu intelligentiae repedit in vu. Et ipse tampam membres vita eloquia sapientiae sue. Et in oratione confitebitur Domino. Et ipse dirige consilium eius, et disciplinam, et in absconditi suis consiliabitur. Ipse palam pace disciplina doctrine sue, et in legi testamenti Domini gloriabitur. Collabamunt multi sapientia meis, et usque in saeculum non delebitur. Non recede memoria eius, et nomen eius recurritur a generatione in generatione. Sapientia eius edarabunt gentes, et laudem eius enunciabi ecclesia. Alleluia, alleluia, amavi Deum Dominus, et ornavi Deum, stolam gloriae inui Deum. Alleluia, justus germinavi sicut Deum, et florendit in aeternum ante Dominum. Alleluia. Dominus Obisum, sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matthei, in illo tempore, dixi Iesu discipulis suis, vos esti sal terrae, quod si sal evanuerit, in quo solietur, ad nihilum valeruntra nisi vomitantur foras, et conducetur ad hominibus. Vos estis lux mundi, non potest civitas abscondi supra montem posita, neque accendunt lucernam, et ponunt aeram sub modio, sed super candelabrum, ut luce ad omnibus qui in domo sunt. Sic luce ad lux vestra coram hominibus, ut vidi ad opera vestra domina, et glorificent patrem vestrum, qui in caelis est. Nolite putare, quoniam veni sobere legem, al prophetas. Non veni sobere, sed ad implere. Amen ite dico vobis, dome transe cilum et terra, iota unum autumus apex per non praeterita lege non et omnia fiat. Qui ergo solveri unum de mandatis istis minimis, et docuerit si comines, minimus vocabitur in regno celorum, qui altem feceric et docuerit hic manus vocabitur in regno celorum.
Mass this morning is being offered for the repose of the soul of David King. Eternal rest granted to him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, for the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Our prayer for vocations. O God, we earnestly beseech thee to bless the church with many priests, brothers, and sisters who will love thee with their whole strength, be faithful to their vocation, and gladly spend their entire lives to teach thy truths, serve thy church, and to make thee known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children. O Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, seminarians, and religious. Obtain for us many more. Amen.
So could you bring the other microphone that's in there?
The prayer to Our Lady of Perpetual Help in this time of pandemic and during the month of May. O Mother of Perpetual Help, grant that I may ever invoke thy powerful name, which is the safeguard of the living and the salvation of the dying. O pure Virgin Mary, O pure Virgin Mary, let your name be henceforth ever on my lips. Whenever I call on you by name, hasten to help me. When I speak your sacred name or even think of you, what consolation and confidence, what sweetness and emotion fill my soul. I thank God for having given you so sweet, powerful, and lovely a name for my good. Let my love for you prompt me ever to greet you as Mother of Perpetual Health. Maria Mater Ecclesiae et Domina Fatima.
Ora pro nobis.
Just a little announcement, nothing big. I just wanted to explain something. Someone asked me about the why I preach every day, because in the traditional Latin Mass, the priests never preach. And that is true generally, and I just think it was the way it was. But I also think that there's a reason why things changed so dramatically with people accepting everything, because they didn't know a lot about what was going on in their religion, especially liturgically. They just went to Mass and that was it. And so I think this is a teaching moment to teach and to explain things that maybe there's no other chance to do it. So for example, today's saint, which I'll talk about in a few moments, that I never knew of until I went to the seminary. I was 20 years old, 18, 19, 20 years old, when I found out about so many of these things, and I thought, why didn't anyone ever tell me about them? So that's why I think it's important to say a few words every day about these different saints and different aspects of the scriptures. The other thing is that when I was a young priest, I remember I didn't rush through Mass, and I took my time, and I remember more than once people coming out to me and saying, Father, you're too long. You take too long. And they would say, when I was growing up, we had a priest who could say Mass in 15 minutes. And I would look at them and I'd say, is that good? You think that's good? You've got to be kidding me. So maybe they did it. I'm not judging their motives. But Mass in 15 minutes, why so fast? To get onto something more important, because Mass is not that important? Where it's just something we get over with so we get on with the rest of the day? No way. That is terrible. Anybody who can say Mass in 15 minutes, in my opinion, is really doing an injustice to the sacred ceremonies that have been passed on to us. So one of our mottos here at Mater is never rush anything. We don't slow it down. We don't make it torturously boring. But we don't speed it up and make it so fast that it's over in 15 minutes either. And so that there's a little sermon every day, it makes it a little longer, but so what? If you're watching now and you're at home, that means that you have all the time in the world to do this because you're not at work. So therefore, this is a blessing in disguise for many because maybe they wouldn't be able to do this every day. So anyway, think of that, and that's why I do what I do. I know it's not the most traditional of customs, but I think this is a custom that probably should be changed because we need it more today than ever. The readings for today's Mass. A lesson from the Book of Wisdom. The just will give his heart to resort early to the Lord that made him, and he will pray in the sight of the Most High. He will open his mouth in prayer and will make supplication for his sins. For if it shall please the great Lord, he will fill him with the spirit of understanding, and he will pour forth the words of his wisdom as showers. And in his prayer he will confess to the Lord, and he shall direct his counsel and his knowledge, and in his secrets shall he meditate. He shall show forth the discipline he hath learned, and shall glory in the law of the covenant of the Lord. Many shall praise his wisdom, and it shall never be forgotten. The memory of him shall not depart away, and his name shall be in request from generation to generation. Nations shall declare his wisdom, and the church shall show forth his praise. A lesson from the of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt lose its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is good for nothing anymore but to be cast out and to be trodden on by men. You are the light of the world. A city seated on a mountain cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but upon a candlestick, that it may shine to all that are in the house. So let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Do not think that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For amen, I say to you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall not pass of the law till all be fulfilled. He therefore that shall break one of these least commandments and shall so teach men shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But he that shall do and teach, he shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven." Thus far the words of the Holy Gospel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. As I was saying, preaching a little sermon every day helps to explain things in the faith. And I remember when I got to the seminary, learning all these things, I was just so overwhelmed by how much information and knowledge and history there is, and I didn't know any of it. So it really whet my appetite to delve in and learn as much as I could. I didn't know that there were distinctions among saints. There are confessors, those who live a good life and do holy works and witness to the faith in a grand, dramatic, miraculous way. There are widows, Saint Monica. There are bishops, pontifex. There are holy men and women, there are martyrs, there are popes, and there are doctors of the church. There are many doctors of the church throughout the history of 2,000 years. A doctor of the church is someone who has great wisdom, who teaches the faith in a magnificent way against all odds in difficult times, or someone who is a great learned person, like St. Thomas Aquinas, who delved theologically into what it means to be a Christian, what our faith means. Well, there are ancient doctors of the church, fathers of the church, that were the most important pillars of orthodoxy in the ancient times that really kind of solidified what we believe in the midst of difficulties right after the church was released from Roman persecution. In the West, we have four great doctors of the church, the four most ancient. They are St. Gregory the Great, St. Ambrose, St. Augustine, and St. Jerome. In the East, prior to these great doctors, were the four doctors, St. John Chrysostom, St. Basil of Caesarea, St. Gregory of Nazianzus, whose feast day is today, and St. Athanasius of Alexandria. If you look at the back wall of St. Peter's Basilica, the great altar of the chair of St. Peter, the chair, the bronze chair, which contains within it the wooden chair that St. Peter used, the symbol of St. Peter's authority, there are four bishops surrounding the throne holding it up. They're like foundation stones. And they are, from left to right, St. Ambrose, a Western doctor, and St. Athanasius, the Eastern doctor. On the other side of the throne is St. John Chrysostom, the Eastern doctor, and on the far right is St. Augustine. These men were so important in the history of the church that they are considered the greatest of teachers, and that's why they have the title of doctor. Well, today we come to St. Gregory of Nazianzus, and I would say that most Catholics have no idea who St. Gregory of Nazianzus is. And they may have heard the name, but they have no idea how important he is in the history of the Catholic faith. I'd like to read to you this little section here on Gregory Nazianzus, and to just give you an idea of who he was and what he did. He lived from 329 AD to 389. The church was set free in 321. And then after that came Julian the Apostate, who tried to persecute the church again. It didn't end. He came back and forth with persecutions. But St. Gregory Nazianzen, he was the son of St. Gregory Nazianzen the Elder, who was a bishop of Nazianzus for 45 years in St. Nona. So his parents were bishop saints, St. Nona and St. Gregory Nazianzen the Elder. He was born at Nazianzus, Cappadocia, which is in Asia Minor, studied at Caesarea, Cappadocia, where he met St. Basil the Great, another Eastern doctor, at the rhetorical school of Caesarea, Palestine, and then for 10 years at Athens, where both Basil and the future Emperor Julian the Apostate were studying. When about 30, Gregory returned to Nazianzus, but soon joined Basil at Pontus on the Iris River to live a life of a solitary, to go off and be a man of prayer by himself, and they would only meet together to help with work or for feeding. After 2 years there, Gregory returned home to assist his father, now over 80, in running the diocese of Nazianzus. He was ordained a priest, mostly willingly, at about 362 by his father, and in about 372, he was named the Bishop of Sasima. The see was in Arian territory. The Arians did not believe that Jesus was fully God. When it was rent by civil strife and had been created by his friend Basil, now Metropolitan of Caesarea and Cappadocia, who had created it in an attempt to offset the claims of the heretical Bishop Antimus of Tiana to the area. So there was all this fighting going on about who Christ was, and there were different dioceses and different bishops fighting each other about it. He suffered a breakdown in 375 and spent the next 5 years in Seleucia, in Syria. On the death of the Emperor Valens and the mitigation of his persecution of the Orthodox, a group of bishops invited Gregory to Constantinople to help revitalize the church there by restoring Orthodoxy to the Arian-dominated city. So the great city of Constantinople, the emperor took the side of the Arians, and so now there was all this infighting on how we're going to read about who Christ is. There, his eloquent preaching at the Church of Anastasia, a house he had converted to a church, brought floods of converts and torrents of abuse and persecution from the Arians and the Apollinaris, another group. He came into controversy with one Maximus, who tried to depose him while he was ill. But Gregory finally prevailed, and in 380, the newly baptized Emperor Theodosius decreed that his subjects must be Orthodox. He ordered the Arian leaders to submit or leave the city and named Gregory Archbishop of Constantinople. Here we went from being a solitary to a priest against his will, made a bishop, thrown into all this controversy. Now he's head of the Byzantine capital of the world and the archbishop. A few months after his installation, hostilities begin anew, and the validity of his election was questioned at the Council of Constantinople in 381, at which he presided. Here they're questioning the authenticity of his appointment at the very council which he's providing at. He resigned to see in the hope of restoring peace now that he had restored Orthodoxy in Constantinople. He retired to private life, lived a life of great austerity, and died at Nazianzus on January the 25th. A doctor of the church, Gregory is often surnamed the theologian for his eloquent defense of the Orthodox teaching that our Lord is Son of God, equal to the Father, and is in a divine person. His decrees that he issued, the decrees of the Council of Nicaea, and his sermons and treatises, notably his celebrated sermons on the Trinity, by theological orations delivered at St. Anastasia in Constantinople. He also wrote a long poem, a Vita Sua, letters, and with St. Basil the Great, compiled a selection of writings by Origen. What a man. And he and St. Basil were friends their whole lives, and they corresponded with each other, they prayed for each other, they helped each other, and we even have letters that they wrote to each other that are still in existence. He was a savior of the church at a time of great conflict. St. Athanasius, we just celebrated him a while back, he was the same. I often think that these bishops would not be welcomed in today's Church of Nice because they never gave in. And they condemned immorality, they condemned untruth, they challenged people to live the faith, and they did it themselves at great cost. We need more like them. St. Gregory, pray for the church today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Christus ut quamo florei, sico cedus, quae illibano est, multiplicabitur, alleluia. Ora te, Patris.
Gesù, che tanto la sacrificio di te, stiamo sedendo a cuore, ma non è solo che lo dico, ma non lo puoi, ma ci sono tutti i suoi sotto sasso.
Per ogni secolo a secolo, Dominus Codiscum,
Spirito Tuo,
Sors in Corda, Grazie Segramus Domino Dea Nostra, Benedictum et Usum Est, Equum et Salutare, Te Quidem Domine, Omni Tempore, Sed in hoc potissimum gloriosimus predicare, Cum Pascha Nostrum Innovatus Est Christus, Ipse in veros est animus, Qui absoni peccata mundi, qui morte nostrum oriente distruxi, et vitam resurgendo reperat, et in iu cum angelis et arcangelis, cum tronis et dominationibus, cumque omni initia celestis exercitus, hymnum gloriae tui canimus, sine in ei gentes, sanctus, 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 dominus Deus salvator, pleni sur cieli et terra gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis. sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Secula secula.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Agnus Dei cui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei cui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei cui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace. Domine nostri Dio. Domine nostri Dio. Domine nostri Dio.
Deus servus et tudens, quem constituit dominus super familiam suam, ut deteris in tempore efficici mensura alia. Dominus vobiscum.
propis nomine tua sacrificia den salute. Beatus Gregorius pontifex tuus et doctor egregius, quesumus precator acceda, per dominum nostrum Jesu Christum filium tuum, qui tegum vivet et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus
sovisum.
Ite missa est. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus sovisum.
Initium
Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem. In principio era verbo, et verbo era tabo Deum, et Deus era verbo. Hoc erat in principio factum Deum. Omnia per ipsum facta sunt, et sine ipsum factum est nihil quo factum est. In ipsum vita erat, et vita erat lux omnium, et lux in tenebris lucet, et tenebre erat non comprehenderat. Cui homo visus ad Deo, cui nunc erat humanus. Hic eniti testimonium, ut testimonium, et igeret in lumine ut omnes credere per illum. Non erat in illustrum testimonium et videret in lumine. Erat lux verque illuminatum in homine veniet in lumen mundum. In nudo erat et nudus per ipsum factus est et nudus eum non coniovit. In proprio veni et sui eum non receperunt. Quod quod autem receperunt eum dei eis potestatem filios dei fiere. His qui credunt in nomine eos, qui non ex sanguinibus, neque ex voluntate carnis, neque ex voluntate viris sed ex Deo natus sunt. Verbum caro factum est, et habitavit in nobis, et vivimus gloria Deus, gloria quasi unigenitia Patre, plenum gratiae veritatis. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tua mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tua mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tua mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Salve Regina, Mater misericordiae, vita dulcedo et spes nostra salve. A te clamamus exules filii ebe. A te suspiramus genentes et plentes, in hac lacrima rupale. Ea ergo advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc auxilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria, ora pro nobis Santa Dei Genetrix. O rebus, Deus refugium nostrum et virtus, populum a te clamantem prohitius vestice, et intercedente gloriosa et immaculata Virgine Dei Genetrice Maria, cum beato Iosef et Alfonso, a beatis apostolis tuis Petro et Paolo, et omnibus sanctis, quas pro conversione peccatorum, pro libertate et exaltatione sancta matris ecclesiae, rece secundibus, misericors et divinus exaudi, per iudum Christum Domino nostrum.
Amen.
Sancte Michael Arcangele, defende nos in prelio, contra nequitiam et insidias diaboli, esto presidium. Imperet qui Deus, supplices de precamo, Tupe princeps militiae celestis, Satanam aliosque spiritus malignos, qui ad perditionem animarum